Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to Simplified by Zinal Shah. In this video, we're going to talk about colchicum autumnal. This is a second year drug, hence it is very important for your exams. And a lot of second year students have been asking me to make more videos which are of second year. So here's one for you. Now what I've done in this video is I've tried to use the concept of art and lettering and divided the word colchicum. Drew little things like this and then made out the symptom. These are taken pictures from my notebook since I did not have real time to make it fresh again, so sorry for the quality. Let's get started. So colchicum ka first letter is C. In this slide we're going to talk about colchicum. So C I've drawn like this. You can see a man who is vomiting and here is some food and this is the smell of it. So colchicum patients have nausea, vomiting and faintness with the smell of food. Okay, and especially of eggs, fish and meat. This is the first symptom and this is the most important symptom, that is aggravation from the smell of food. Second letter is the O. I've made a huge distended abdomen to show that the remedy has abdomen distended immensely with gas and he feels as if it would burst any moment. Alright, then this is L. Whatever has the highlighter has GI complaints. L shows us this is the stools, this is the intestinal lining, and here the dysentery has intestinal scrapings. So the stool contains scrapings of intestine. It is offensive. The stool is well as flatus and frequent, profuse and abundant. Alright, so the same thing we go for the C here, that is the second C of colchicum. Second C, these are the two lips if anybody cannot notice it well, and this thing that you can see dropping off is saliva. So colchicum patients have profuse abundant saliva, secretion of saliva, that is the other C. So we have nausea, vomiting, smell, distended abdomen, intestinal scrapings and stool, and the second C contained profuse secretion of saliva. Next we go on to the other letters. This is H. Okay, so H I have shown two soles and the feet. So the patient has stubbed toe and he screams. So you can see the screaming voices here. Patient screams with pain when touching joint or stubbed toe and there is tingling pain in the toes. So we have to remember that colchicum is a good remedy for rheumatism as well. So all these symptoms can be added in the section of rheumatism as well. Then we have the I. I've drawn a pen. This is an ink pen. You can see a paper here. So just to emphasize that this is ink pen. The urine is inky in color. So there is inky urine, sour, acidic, dark colored, copious with blood which is decomposed. So you can almost think of this as red or brownish to ink colored urine. Alright, then we have another C. This is a guy passing flatus in the third C. So also you have to remember that this C also stands for cholera or gastralgia and flatulence. The stools are yellow, mucus has blood in it and there is violin tenesmus. So this remedy also has a good amount of tenesmus and pain which we see in the other remedies like colocynth or macfos. Here the common symptoms that you can relate is the distended abdomen which causes the flatus and the cholera and dysentery with mucus and blood in it, and the stool color is yellowish. Alright. Then we come to U. This is almost like a hemorrhoid and I've tried to draw a spasm here. So there is spasm of sphincter and during discharge of stool which makes it very difficult for the person to pass stool. So either a person can have diarrhea or dysentery or they can have difficulty in passing stool. This is very common in almost all remedies where they also show some action on diarrhea and some action on constipation. So here the person has ineffectual urging. And this is M. If anybody cannot really see, then I'll draw it. Okay, this is M. There is tingling numbness in finger and nails. Okay, so maybe you can make it out now. So your HICUM was stubbed toe, patient screams, inky urine, flatus, cholera, U is spasm of sphincter, and M is tingling in fingernails. All right, so easy. This is one of my favorite remedy presentation, I guess, and I think cyclamen as well. So you can check that video out as well. We go ahead to the second part, which is autumnal. Now I have not arranged autumnal in the exact order as it comes, but I have done few letters here and there. Let's see. The first and the most important symptom or the thing that you're supposed to mention is ailments from. I've drawn A and I've drawn autumn leaves. It's not, I mean, it might not be really visible, but that was the idea and the plan. So the ailment from is autumn, which is not a big brainer because the name itself is autumnal. So that is A. There are other ailments from as well, which is misdeeds of other, grief, getting wet. So all these will are supposed to be added with, you can't forget these ailments from, okay? Especially misdeeds of others in autumn. These two are the most important ones. Another ailments from here, I've drawn a T, if you can see. This is a man, this is the axilla. So another ailment from is suppressed perspiration, and if there is perspiration, we would like to correlate it with exercise. So either with exercise and suppressed perspiration, and the above few ailments from which we just mentioned completes your ailments from section. Let us also add on the aggravation and amelioration through the A. Aggravation is from motion, touch, and summer. Motion, summer, both cause perspiration, and touch, we've seen in the last slide as well that the stubbed toe, the patient will scream with touch. Amelioration is with rest and lying down. Ameliorating modalities are usually the opposite of the aggravating modality. So again, this is no big brainer. Now, as I mentioned previously, that colchicum is a great remedy for rheumatism. So let us see the locations where rheumatism is present. Alright, so again we'll go ahead with the words. We've done A and T. In this section we are doing L. I will use a blue marker. This is L. Okay, so L is telling us about neck and clavicle. Okay, you can see here, neck and clavicle. Then we go to N, I'll use red for N. You can see here, this is an N. Alright, oopsie. So, you get my point. This is the N, and N is showing us shoulders, elbows, and finger joints. Alright, and then we have M. M is quite visible. You can see here, this is an M. So, again, for M, we have hips, thighs, knees, and the soles and the foot. So that is M. These are the locations for rheumatism. Knee joint and toe. Alright, so these are locations. Now there's going to be sensation. So I've drawn another A here, you can see, of autumn nail. Drawn a flight about that. Let's say it is Air India. So the A component comes out here. And the pains here are flying pains, tearing pains, and tendency to move from one joint to another. Okay, so the planes have the tendency to move from one place to another. I hope you can correlate. All of these things are really, really poetic, which is why I love it, absolutely love it. And you can actually put in your own creativity and thoughts into it. So A stands for flying pains or Air India. We're almost done here. U is for urine. There is urging for urine, and more the urging, there is more the pain. Another U thing which we had was inky urine, so I'm maintaining the color with decomposed blood. So there is urging in urine which causes pain, more urging, more discharge, and urethra feels raw. This is not a very important symptom. according to me, but it might really be important, who knows. And then lastly we come to E. E is just simple E, nothing more creative with it. So E is external impressions, like light, noise, strong odors, contact, and bad manners. All of these external impression, they cause aggravate their complaints. This is very similar to bryonia, if you see. All right, so we have A, U, T, A, M, N, A here for aggravation and amelioration, L, and an E. So this is autumnal. We are done with this remedy, colchicum autumnal. I think this is one of my favorite presentation. I wish I could have done it much better. Maybe I'll redo the video later on when I have enough time. Thank you for subscribing to the channel, everyone who has. We are almost close to 1 year of starting with this channel. Like this video and share it with your friends so they can also come check it out. And here is the playlist of remedies A to C. You can check out all the drugs of that playlist here. Thank you.